What should someone look for when shopping for a high quality LED grow light? The first thing is the PAR values. PAR is really the measure of energy being put out from a fixture that is actually hitting your plants. I still listen to a lot of videos and they talk about lumens and they talk about watts. Lumens are what the intensity of light is to your eye, and watts are what you pay for. I always tell people, if somebody talks about lumens, don't even consider that as far as a high quality grow light. And the reason is, it's PAR energy. Lumens do not include all of that energy that plants need to grow. PAR energy is the measure, and it is measured typically with a PAR meter that looks like this. For seed starting in microgreens, you want between 100 and 200 micromoles of photons per square meter per second, which is PPFD, photosynthetically photon flux density. And you want between 150 and 300 to grow plants to full maturity like this. And you want, let's say, 300 and more if you're going to grow a tomato to full maturity. So that is the single most important factor to start with. One of the biggest improvements that LED grow lights have is that they've significantly increased the efficiency, or the correct term is actually efficacy. So because you're measuring the amount of light or photons per unit of watt or joules, and that term is truly efficacy, but efficiency is a clear way to be able to say that. So to give you an idea, is in an incandescent bulb, which is really what our first sources of lights are, only about 4% of the light coming out of an incandescent bulb is light. 96% is heat. In a fluorescent, we made a pretty significant improvement, and about 20% of the light coming out of a fluorescent is actually light, and the other 80% is still heat. With an LED, with the high efficiency LEDs that are out there now, almost 50% of the light coming out of it is visible for light that actually can be used to grow your plants. You still have 50% heat, but you can see, compared to an incandescent bulb, it's about 10 times more efficient and about 2.5 or 3 times more efficient than a fluorescent bulb. The other factor that's really important with LEDs is now you can tune the exact colors of them. So one thing that's often overlooked is the optimal spectrum for plant growth. The slide that we're going to put up here that will show you the differences in how plants grow relative to the spectrum used. And this is all research done at universities like Michigan State and Purdue. And what they have found is if you use the right color LEDs and the right ratio of them, that you will get up to 2.5 times more plant mass and growth, and faster than just using the white LEDs that are often the imported Chinese lights that you can get on Amazon or Home Depot. How do you actually determine or measure efficiency or efficacy of a grow light? The term that's used is micromoles per joule. If you've taken chemistry in high school, you probably remember the term mole, which is actually a number. It's called Avogadro's number, and it is a measure of how many atoms in carbon per gram. Not important to know here, but it's a number that's used to measure the number of photons coming out of a light source. So they use typically the term micromoles, which is a millionth of a mole of photons per joule of energy. And so you want that number to be as high as possible. For a commercial grower, that's really important because they pay a big electric bill every month. And so they want as much light coming out of that fixture for the amount of their electric bill. So a good number for a grow light is 2.5 micromoles per joule. And that would include the energy losses from your power supplies and everything else. Some suppliers put a number like 2.8 on there, but they don't include the energy that is wasted in a power supply. So one of the questions that we regularly get is, do I need to go out and buy a PAR meter if I want to do my indoor gardening? And the answer is no, for several reasons. One is, a PAR meter is something that allows you to determine what the level or intensity of light is. But if you're buying, for instance, a happy leaf light, we give you all of the information you need about how high to set it, how long to keep it on for various types of plants. How long should I leave my lights on? That is what's called a photoperiod. So where that becomes really important is if you have a fruiting or a flowering plant. We typically recommend a 16 to 18 hour photoperiod. So you should look up the type of plant you're growing and determine if you need to set the timer to a certain photoperiod at the fruiting or flowering stage. But in general, if you just use 16 to 18 hours a day for your indoor garden, you'll do absolutely fine. Those are the really, really important factors in how do you determine the light that will allow you to grow indoors all year long, highly successfully. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.